Meghan Markle adds a lot of new challenges for Harry's family, royal biographer says. He also reveals how Diana would really feel about her son's soon-to-be wife. "We have less than 30 days to go until the royal wedding, and America is here for it." There are royal wedding countdown groups on Facebook, entire Etsy pages devoted to celebratory items like "I'd Marry Harry" hats, and freshly bound biographies on both Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. That's in addition to a national gossip sesh every time they step out in public between now and May 19. The most distinguished authority in the fray is arguably Andrew Morton, who published Diana, Her True Story in 1992. Princess Diana famously sent him taped recordings of her side of the story. On Tuesday, he released Meghan, a Hollywood Princess, chronicling Markle's upbringing and career as an actress, followed by six chapters devoted to her current relationship. Good Housekeeping. Com spoke over the phone with Morton to get his thoughts on Harry and Meghan's written in the stars romance, and what Diana would have to say about it, if only she were alive today. Good Housekeeping. Com. You wrote about the fact that she sort of got him to clean up his party animal act. Do you think that will last, after the marriage? Andrew Morton. Not only will it last, the thing about American women is that they're very good at changing their men, in lots of small ways. I think you'll see him wearing snappier suits and clothes, at some point. GH, unpack that a little bit. What do you mean by changing their men in lots of small ways? AM, like, the kind of suits they wear, the kind of clothes they wear. Personal habits. She will presumably rule the roost in the kitchen. She will be asserting herself. She seems like a very assertive young woman. GH, it's refreshing to see her wear what some people call a messy bun instead of perfect hair every time she's with Harry in public, and hug children, which you don't really see members of the royal family doing. She's trying to fit in, but she's also not. Where do you think that comes from? AM, I think she's being herself. When you look at pictures of her before she met Harry, when she was on missions to Rwanda, specifically, as part of World Mission Canada, she was kneeling down with kids and cuddling them, getting her pictures taken with them, just getting down to their level. I think that's something that comes naturally to her. GH, certain members of Meghan Markle's family have been very outspoken since her engagement to Prince Harry, saying she invited complete strangers to the wedding over family. What are your thoughts on that? AM, it would be very sad if the guest list overshadows the wedding. Samantha, who's made that criticism, feels that some members of the Markle family should have been invited. It is ironic that a few days before the wedding, there will be a Markle coat of arms. Traditionally, that's presented to the father. As I speak now, it's not certain that he's even going. I spoke to members of the Markle family over the weekend, and they said that not one Markle has been invited, and that includes the father. So, go figure. GH, just to clarify, there were some reports that she wanted him to walk to her down the aisle. So you're saying that up until now, he hasn't received an invitation? AM, at the moment, he doesn't seem to have his invitation. As far as I'm aware, he doesn't have an air ticket accommodation, or anything else. It looks increasingly like it will be Doria Radlin, Meghan's mother, who will walk her down the aisle. GH, you of course also wrote the biography on Princess Diana. What do you think she'd think of Meghan, if she were still alive today?